the whole cosmos. And yet, he lowered himself to be subject to a human body like ours. We don't get what that means, giving up glory, where it's pure and holy and perfect. And he had all everything, right? He's the all-sufficient one, to come and live in an earthen vessel. You know, they get sick. That's why Pastor Bill's not here. They get weak. They get tired. They get all kinds of stuff. But more than that, he subjected himself to our sins, which are much more vile to him than they are to us.
Amen.
And he did that out of so much love. And so let us rejoice today in the magnificence of who our God is. That he is the Almighty, and yet he is merciful. Right? That he is full of power, but he's also full of compassion. That he's not willing that any should perish, that he loves each and every one of us so much, all the time. When we're doing well and when we're not, he loves us so much. And he paid such a big price to buy us out of darkness, amen, buy us out of bondage and slavery, and bring us into freedom. Let us just rejoice in who our God is today. What a great Savior we have. And you know, behind the election, some of you are happy and some of you are sad. Some of you are hopeful and some of you are afraid. But I'm telling you, King Jesus is on the throne no matter who the president is.
Yes.
And he can work through anybody. And if we will do what we're supposed to do as the church, right? Yes. If my people will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked way.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
My people, not everybody out here in this world, his people, and seek my face. Then he'll come and heal our land. And so let us rejoice in what a wonderful Savior we have and understand that he can bring a spiritual awakening to this city and this nation if whose people?
His people.
It's us. That's right. Okay, so let's just rejoice in that. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, I'm going to go through the announcements.